also to take this wonderful opportunity after the dedication of our portable baptistry, that I'd like to recognize the effort and help of Mr. Robert Hall and Big Nicano to do the finishing touches by staining and putting varnish and shellac to our baptistry.
Amen.
And both of them dedicated their time in between their job, coming in back and forth, to come finish this so we can have it finished today. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Since we're talking about baptism today, we have an option, because the plan of having baptism before this baptistry arrives. So, the candidates thought that when we are planning a baptism, they have baptism at the beach. What's the name of the beach again? Sand Bridge Beach. Okay, they said by 1:30 we'll find out. We'll be going there. We're elected by the church. First option is for us to go there. And they will give us direction, right? And since this is a church celebration, I'd like to invite you to be a part of that celebration. You know, any wonderful occasion in the church, if you're a part of the church, you'll be with us, right? Because if you believe you are the small part of this church, he still a small finger will still follow wherever the body goes, right? Amen. So we'd like to invite the body of the church to join us, right? Amen. And 1:30 they told me that they will find out the weather forecast. Let's pray. Everything will work out okay.
Amen.
Okay. Then, as we said in our prayer, let's make use of this one. Can we do that? Amen. Not only paying the bills for this one. I'm not concerned about that one, because the Lord will fill that up. And I would like to see, as much open as we do this, make use of this baptistry. Our deacons will be very happy in deaconesses to see more people than brought in this baptism. Okay, for the last month, we've been talking about witnessing evangelism. Okay, and you notice we focus on one text. You remember the text? Luke chapter 10, verse 2. And we start with letter A. What does it mean, letter A? The harvest truly is great. Do you believe in that? The thing was, sometimes we don't open our eyes. So our prayer was, Lord, open our eyes that we may see the harvest truly is great. You know, today is a very significant day of this church. Because today is a 150-year celebration of Seventh-day Adventists when they organized the church. Whoa! And they asked the church, the worldwide church, to pray for this one. Although the great challenge by Elder Ted Wilson during their annual council, he said, wish we're no longer here, because they've been preaching the Advent message of the Lord. But still, while we're still in this world, we need to do what we need to do, share the mission of this church. So June 7th at the Big Apple, New York City, Elder Ted Wilson started preaching, but they've done the preparation for more than a year. And it is interesting, for the first time in the history of this church, the worldwide church will come together in Big Apple. All division, we have representation, and started doing the preaching, the gospel in Big Apple, New York City. Now we had the privilege to be there on the last week of June to witness the International Field School Evangelism leadership of Pastor Ted Wilson and Pastor Mark Finley. But as a church, we are blessed to know that the harvest truly is great. But what's the problem then? Letter B. The laborers are few. But we found out the laborers are few. There are few laboring laborers. Why? Because they are distracted. Remember in the gospel we found out distracted because of the business activity. One said, well, I can't go with the invitation because I have property to look at. Then the other one said, well, I have my oxen, I'll check it out first. Then the other one, I was just newly married, a relationship. They're distracted. Other laborers are what? Discouraged because there are so many things to do, but there are few laborers. That's why it's very discouraging for those working. So find out tomorrow how many laborers or laborers come here for work pay. Right? Let's check it out. I would like to encourage you. That's one indication. Then, as we focus again, Luke chapter 10, verse 2. Let's talk about this one. And this is the conclusion they said. Therefore, pray the Lord of the harvest. Pray the Lord of the harvest to send out laborers into his harvest. So we found out the harvest truly is great, but there are few laboring laborers. How many were called? All of us. All of us experience the commitment to Jesus' baptism are called to be his laborers. But there are few laboring laborers. So our goal this morning is to pray for the Lord of the harvest to send out what? Laborers. Have you ever prayed a bold prayer in your life? While walking up and down, Joe, to Spira, thank you so much for your help. Brother Elder Joe has been a great help to us. I don't think it would be a wonderful experience without Elder Joe, he said, because he was not only a driver, but he is. When he said to the boys, "Boys, keep quiet." And I was, but I know it was that his intention to stay out of the room because he said, "Pastor, you're in the lion's den." I said, "Why?" "I'm with the five boys in one room." But I enjoy it because they are so respectful. And I enjoy the time together. Know what I'm saying here? Have you ever prayed bold prayer? Because I remember while walking up and down to the Skyrim. It reminds me of my experience at Mountain View College, Mr. Ely, going up to the mountain and learn. Our prayers were us to reach the top. And we started walking from 10 noontime. You know what time we reached the top? 12 midnight.
Wow.
Because there was no trail like that. It's total darkness. You can see anything. Close your eyes. You not see nothing. You could feel the rain. And the instructor said, "Ellie, would you like to stay with Miss Lucy, one of our elementary teachers, because we're lost." Okay. But how long? I don't know. So look at her. It was 7 o'clock in the evening, total darkness. And they arrived 8 o'clock, an hour waiting. But my prayer, "Lord, help me." Have you ever prayed like that? "Lord, save me." One scripture in the Bible, I invite you to open your Bible. I intentionally let to put this in the scripture so we can use our Bible. 1 Kings 7:21. Join with me. 1 Kings 7:21, I would say. And here's the verse. "And he stretched himself out on the child 3 times, and he cried out to the Lord and said," who's saying this? Is Elijah's prayer. "O Lord my God, I pray, let this child's soul come back to him." Is that a regular prayer? This is a bold prayer of Elijah. "O Lord my God." And he asked that, "I pray, let this child's soul come back to him." So what do you think of Luke 10:10, 10:2? It may not sound a radical prayer, but it said, "Therefore, pray for the Lord of the harvest, knowing that the harvest truly is great, but the laborers are few." So the verse tells us, pray for the Lord of the harvest. You know, in Greek word, it comes from the word deumai, which means to beseech, to plead earnestly, to beg. Asking for the Lord of the harvest, because there are very few laboring laborers. The harvest truly is great. So what we need to do is to beseech, to plead earnestly, to beg. Remember in Luke chapter 5 verse 12, let's open again our Bible. 5 verse 12, I invite you to turn on your electronic Bible if you have. make use of this one. He said, Lord, if you're willing, you can make me clean. That's another bold prayer. If you ever pray like this, well, for sure, heaven pray because you're not having some leprosy. But this guy said, Lord, if you're willing, you can make me clean. Another verse in the Bible, Luke 8:38. A man who earnestly begging with Jesus. Join with me reading again, 8:38. Now the man from the demons have departed, begging him that he might be with him, but Jesus sent him away. He said, Lord, can I go with you? Asking, begging. The word the Yuma has been used in those verses. Another, Luke 9:38. This is the verse we're talking here is the verse in Greek, the Yuma means begging. And he's pleading. 9:38 that says, Teacher, I implore you, look on my son, for he is my only child. So if you look on the verse that was used in the Gospel of Luke chapter 10, verse 2, it's the same verse, or the same Greek word, the human. Because they are pleading, they're earnestly pleading, they're beseeching, they are asking the Lord, they're begging for this one. A man is pleading for his own deliverance from the evil. The question, what does it sound like? Was it just an ordinary prayer, Lord, bless this food. Amen. This is not a regular prayer. That's why the word that you might be used, I want you to understand. Again, Luke 22:31. This was the statement, prayer of Jesus for Peter. If you're following me, and you'll find out the same verse been used, or the same Greek word. Okay, 31. And the Lord said, Simon, Simon, indeed Satan has asked for you that he may ship you as a wheat. But I have prayed for you, how do you like that? That your faith should not fail when you have returned to me, strengthen your brethren. So here we are, Jesus was what? Earnestly pleading with the Father on behalf of Peter. Because he knew that Peter will be shifted up like a wheat by Satan. But he is asking the Father, what? That Peter will be what? Be strengthened in the next period. So the word that was used from Greek in Luke chapter 10, verse 2, the third part in the conclusion, Lord, pray for the harvest, the same word was emphasized, the human. Pray earnestly, beg, pray to the Lord of the harvest. And therefore, pray for the Lord of the harvest. Because there are very few laboring laborers, the harvest truly is great. So our prayer concern is that he will send out. Interesting, in the Greek there is the word imperative. They talk about command or appeal. But much more, in imperative tense, they said there is an active response. When Jesus said this, Matthew 7:7, invite you to open with me again to the Gospel of Matthew. And here's the Bible. Ask, it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find, nothing will be open to you. But Jesus said, you are already asking, continue to ask, keep on asking. That's the word they used. So after that, what God wants is to have an active response from them. Are you following what Jesus is saying? Ask, it will be given to you. Seek, and you will find. Knock, it will be opened to you. So Jesus said, you are already asking. Continue to ask. Keep on asking. Because in Greek, the oldest imperative start doing something what you're not doing. Okay, the first one, it's something to do with the command, appeal, and active response. But it has also always imperative, that means you have to start doing something what you're not yet doing. Let's another example here. John 11:44. Remember, this was the example in the Gospel of John, where Jesus and his friend Lazarus this is not usual event that happened, because it found out when he died, when he had died, come out again and food with great clothes, and his face was wrapped in the cloth. Jesus said to him, loose him and let him go. Do you think Lazarus will experience an experience that something haven't experienced before? They need someone who went to lose him. That's why he said, start and dropping him, let him go. Start running. Meaning to say, start praying earnestly. You're not praying as you should. You need to start earnestly pleading with the Lord of the harvest. That what? That he will send laborers. Laborers. Okay. You may ask, why do I need to pay? Knowing that the harvest truly is great in Virginia Beach area, but laboring are few. The laborers are very few. They are called laborers. Laboring are very few. Why? Some of them are distracted, some are discouraged. No, the question is, why do I need to beg after knowing the harvest really is great? Why? Because it has nothing to do with changing of my heart than changing God's heart. In other words, we are asking, we're giving God's permission to do something radical in my life. You want us to be a laborers, but sometimes we are discouraged, we are distracted. So at this point, the prayer is giving God permission to do something radical in my life. If I want to be a laboring laborers, it's time for us to ask this prayer. Therefore, pray to the Lord of the harvest that he will send you out. Here the word sent out is not exact Greek translation, because sent out the laborers comes from the Greek word is herge. That tells us the Greek word means ek balo. Means ek is out of. Balo means to cast or to throw. That simple definition of word tells us. So instead of sending out, the word is to cast or to throw the laborers. When the disciple cast their nets, the word balo or ekbalo has been used. John 21:6. Join with me again. If you want to follow, you will understand the verse tells us here in John chapter 21, verse 6. Join with me and we could understand. And he said to them, cast the net, ekbalo, on the right side of the boat, and you will find some. So he didn't say, send the net. He said, throw out the net, or cast out the net. Another verse, John 8:59. Remember this verse, if you look into this particular gospel, you'll find out that then they took up stones to throw at him. But Jesus hid himself and went out of the temple, going through the midst of them, and so passed by. So when the enemies of Jesus picks up the rock to throw at him, they use the word ekbalo. So what Jesus is asking us this morning is, let's plead to the Lord of the harvest to throw out laborers, to cast out laborers into his harvest. And those laborers might be you and me. Lord of the harvest, I beg earnestly you to draw out laborers